worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened, worshipless Buddha, consummated in knowledge and behavior. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened, worshipless Buddha, consummated in knowledge and behavior. Totally transcended, expert in all dimensions, knower of all worlds, unsurpassable trainer of those who can be trained, both teacher and guide of gods as well as of humans, blessed, exalted, awakened, and perfectly self-enlightened, worshipless Buddha. Perfectly formulated is this Buddha Dhamma, visible right here and now, immediately effective, timeless, inviting each and everyone to come and see for themselves. Inspect, examine, and verify, leading each and everyone through progress towards perfection. Directly observable, experienceable, and realizable by each intelligence. Perfectly training is this noble Sangha community of the Buddha's noble disciples. They are training the right way, the true way, the good way, the direct way. Therefore, to these eight kind of individuals, these four noble pairs, deserve both gifts, self-sacrifice, offerings, hospitality, and reverential salutation, the joint palms. Since this noble Sangha community of the Buddha's noble disciples is an unsurpassable and indeed forever unsurpassed field of merit in this world, for this world, to honor, respect, support, uphold, and protect.
Hello friends, and welcome to one of my favorite places, a steep down cliff hillside with a small cave behind us where I took cover when I went Pindabat many times for the rain. Doesn't look so, but it's more than 50 degrees steep down here, and there's another cave down there. Well, down this path there's another cave, small cave, and here you see it's very nice with uphill, the way the trees cling with tree roots coming down all the way up the stone and cliffs, and hairy roots is falling down. But under here, this small, small overhang is a good production site. You can see some people have made tea here before, small fireplace. This is a good production site. So one can even be behind the roots here for a new, what would I say, series and a new video log.
Hello to you friends, a small video log on a small issue I came about in the last poor day. I was reading Digha Nikaya number 16, which you see here. The last days of the Buddha, which tells a story on 50 pages about the last three months of the Buddha. Very good reading from the first book of the Sutta Pitaka that should be read by all Buddhists, monastic and lays, at least three times before they die. And happily, I said this before, and a recent Buddhist, a truck driver from the US, he has just today ordered the Digha Nikaya to read. So I can recommend that. Some of the texts are free, I'll give the links below, but they are not all translated. They are all translated now into English. And there's several translations. The book is also nice to have. It's a green color from Wisdom Publications with the English translation by Maurice Walsh. There's also a commentary to the Digha Nikaya number 16, and this has been published by the Pali Text Society. And as you see, it's just a red book this size, which is the commentary translated word for word. And I'll also give the link below to that. But nevertheless, it so happened that the Buddha was asked by Mara to relinquish his life, because now he had done what he should do. He should set the sasana going, and there should be many scores of lay people and monks and nuns knowing the Dhamma by heart, and it should be a forest of nobles, both male and female, and by monks and nuns in the Sangha. And this has happened. So he came back and asked the Buddha, now this has happened, please go into Parinibbana. Please go into Nibbana without remnant remaining, and thereby leave your body, basically. Die. And so the Buddha say, evil one, don't trouble yourself too much, because 3 months from now, I will die. Up to this then, he travels about with 500 monks, and this number, among them Venerable Anananda. And then Venerable Ananda thought to himself, whatever small city we come to here, then I will ask Buddha about this and that person that has recently died, that was a noble, whether they were noble or not, so they can be declared noble. And this happens then in a series of villages. And around 50 persons, the Buddha declared that they were so-and-so, they were stream entrant, they were once returners, and they were anagamis, never returners, and so on. But eventually he said, because it was troublesome for him to, whenever he come, in the last 3 months of his life, to diagnose all who has died there recently, whether they were noble or not, then he gave this small lecture of the mirror of the Dhamma, whereby you can diagnose yourself and others can diagnose you whether you are noble or not. And I think this is a very good, since it's up in discussion, I think this is a very good teaching to set forth this mirror of the Dhamma, because it's always good to look in the mirror and see this thing I call self. How is it really? How is it behaving? Now, how was it behaving verbally, mentally, bodily in the past? Can I improve how it will behave intentionally in the future? So he said, friends, listen and pay attention and I will speak. I will give you the teaching called the Mirror of the Dhamma, possessing which the noble disciple, should he so desire, can declare of him himself. There's no more rebirth for me in hell, nor as an animal, nor as a ghost, nor in the realm of woe. A stream enterer am I, safe from falling into states of misery. Assured am I, and bound for enlightenment. Such noble disciple possesses confirmed faith, confidence and conviction in the Buddha in this way. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened is the Buddha, consummated in knowledge and behavior, totally transcended, expert in all dimensions, knower of all worlds, unsurpassable trainer of those who can't be tamed, both teacher and guide of gods, devas, as well as of humans, blessed, exalted, awakened, and enlightened, is the Buddha. He possesses confirmed confidence in the Dhamma in this way. Perfectly formulated is this Buddha Dhamma, visible right here and now and wherever, immediately effective, timeless, akaliko, inviting each and everyone to come and see for themselves, inspect, examine, and verify, leading each and everyone through progress towards perfection. Directly observable, experienceable, and realizable by each intelligence. He also possesses confirmed confidence in the Sangha in this way. Perfect training is the noble Sangha of the Buddha's disciples. The right way, the true way, the good way, the straight, direct way. Therefore do these eight kind of individuals, the four noble pairs, deserve both gifts, self-sacrifice, offerings, hospitality, and reverential salutation with joined palms. Since this noble Sangha community of the Buddha's noble disciples, the Arya Sangha, a subset of the Sammuchi Sangha, the conventional Sangha, is an unsurpassable and forever unsurpassed field of merit, a probability lifter in this world, for this world, to honor, support, respect, and protect. Lastly, fourth article. Watch out. He possesses the moral purity esteemed by the noble ones, an ethical past and present, a morality that is unbroken, untorn, unspotted, unmuddled, freeing, praised by the clever, natural, leading to the mental concentration and absorption. This, Ananda, is a teaching called the Mirror of the Dhamma, whereby the noble disciple may thus know of himself, there is no more rebirth for me in hell, nor as an animal, nor as a ghost, nor in any realm of woe, of suffering, of fear, of anxiety and agony. A stream enterer, Suttapana, am I, safe from falling into the states of misery, assured am I, bound for enlightenment, bound for enlightenment, bound for enlightenment within seven lives at most. So, four articles is the mirror of the Dhamma. Assured confidence and conviction, there is complete absence of any trace of skeptical doubt, ambiguity, or hesitation about the absolute supremacy of the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Arya Sangha. And then the most difficult one, a moral purity that is unbroken, untorn, unspotted, unmuddled, freeing, praised by the clever, natural and leading to mental absorption. Is that good to look at oneself in this mirror once in a while before one's dreams about this and that state runs wild, huh? This ego wants to gratify itself. Then look at this mirror and be brutally honest. Again, be brutally honest. Again, be brutally honest. Huh? So don't make any mistake to fall into, I'm this or that, or they are he or she is this or that, and thereby mistake superstition or self-gratification for a fact. That is not the case. This is a standard, of course, unfortunately, to do so. And the Buddha waited until the very last moment to declare these four kinds of noble. The stream entrant, coming back here to this samsara, only seven times at most. The once returner who go to a divine existence and come back here and enlightened. Come back here only one more time. And those who go to the pure abodes, the anagamis, the never returners, in order to be enlightened there in a subsequent existence. And those arahants that are stainless now, that have done the job, mission complete, they put down the burden. There's no more for them to do, except smiling. Thank you for your clever attention, kind consideration, and advantageous contribution. May you have indeed a nice and noble day. Namo Tassu Bhagavato Arahato Samma Sambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the Blessed Buddha, indeed. Remember, the mirror of the Dhamma, mind seeing mind, mind seeing mind, mind seeing mind, while being brutally honest and very dry and realistic about what it sees. Thank you.
You heard Bhikkhu Sammahita from the Cypress Hermitage on the Knuckles Mountain, Pamparela, Central Hill Country, Sri Lanka. Please subscribe to the Google group Buddha Direct and visit the website whatbuddhasaid.net. May all beings become thus happy thereby. Thank you. Namo Tassa Bhagavato Arahato Sammasambuddhassa. Worthy, honorable, and perfectly self-enlightened was the Blessed Buddha. Thank you for your contribution, and have a nice day.